So I already filmed the intro to this video, but it was so insufferably bad that I had to refilm it. This video is going to be me listing my top 13 favorite Taylor Swift songs, and I know Taylor Swift has a fuck ton of songs, and this list definitely fluctuates, but currently these are my top 13 favorite Taylor Swift songs. Now, before I get into my list, I will give a little backstory as to how I became a Swiftie. And if you don't care about that and you just want to see my list, then you can go to this timestamp over here. And I really hope it's accurate. If not, my deepest apologies. Now that I think about it, I kind of fucking look like the Joker. But it's okay, I'll just listen to The Joker and the Queen. I don't really know where to begin. Okay, so I first heard of Taylor Swift when Fearless came out. I'm an only child, which meant as a kid, I didn't really have anyone to play with except my two cousins. My cousin actually introduced me to Taylor Swift, and When You Belong With Me came out. I don't actually know if my cousin knew about Taylor Swift during her debut era, but I did know that she was already a diehard Taylor Swift fan before we watched the You Belong With Me music video. She showed that to me. I was shook, but I wasn't really moved. I was just really obsessed with the music video, but I was like, what, like six? My cousin is 2 years older than me, and she was the one who introduced me to stan culture. Now, we didn't know the term stan culture, but it was definitely stan culture at the time. She introduced me to so many popular bands like Lady Gaga, Taylor Swift, One Direction. Like, Taylor Swift was her artist and One Direction was mine. I wasn't a diehard Swiftie until Reputation came out. Don't quote me on this, but I'm pretty sure that my cousin and I watched 2009 MTV Music Awards with the whole Kanye interruption thing, but I don't really remember because I was way too young. I wasn't part of Twitter when Taylor Swift was being canceled in 2016. I wouldn't really consider myself a Swiftie during the 1989 era, but I didn't hate her. If you did and you're a Swiftie now, that's totally fine. Do you deserve the Taylor Swift Eras tour tickets? Questionable. Totally kidding, by the way. Please don't cancel me. Yeah, I respect all the Swifties who came before me. Okay, so this is a bit hard for me to say, but I'm going to speak my truth. I believe that I deserve financial compensation for Evermore being my favorite album. Okay, so I just wrote down my list, and holy fuck, this was so hard to do because I listen to Taylor Swift's entire discography on a daily basis. Also, I don't really get it when Swifties like hate on another Swiftie for liking a song more than another, or like disliking a song, blah blah blah. Like, we all collectively like Taylor Swift's entire discography. Like, it's merely just like simple discourse. Like, it's not like, like, it won't change your life. So can we just like not be mean about it in the comments or something? Okay, starting off strong with number 13, we have from the Fearless album, The Best Day. Now, this song is about Taylor Swift's family. I think it also primarily focuses on her mom. This song just gives me Gilmore Girls vibes. And if you watch Gilmore Girls, you would know that Taylor Swift is the real life version of Lorelai Gilmore. There's just so many similarities. They literally look the same. Like, she looks like Taylor Swift in the Wildest Dreams music video because of the black hair. And just like their mannerisms are the same, their wit. Like, it's just, she's mother. Number 12 is Sparks Fly. I fucking love Sparks Fly. It's such a catchy song. Guitar in the beginning gets me grooving. Number 11, we have Dress. Reputation is the first album that really got me into Taylor Swift and like knowing a lot about her and like actually like researching who she is. And I do believe Reputation is one of her greatest works. Like, it's definitely like in my top three albums. And unfortunately, Dress is the only Reputation song on this list. Because although Reputation is an album that comments on the backlash that Taylor Swift got in 2016, it's also a love album. Some Swifties even claim that Reputation and Lover are sister albums, like Folklore and Evermore. However, my reason as to why there's only one Reputation song on this list is because I can't relate to a lot of songs on there. Moving on, we have Would've, Could've, Should've coming in at number 10. It's the only Midnight song on this list because I haven't listened to Midnight's as much as I have the other albums. Give Me Back My Girlhood, It Was Mine First. People fucking died, and by people, I mean me. I fucking died in my bed listening to that. My soul ascended, was brought right back down, Jesus style. I then resurrected and then bawled my fucking eyes out. At number 9, we have Last Kiss. She wrote this by herself at, I believe, age 19. A 6-minute ballad. Also, it kind of sounds like Heather by Conan Gray.
I still remember the look on your face.
I still remember 3rd of December.
Like, they just kind of sound the same. At number 8, we have Afterglow. I fucking love Heartstopper, and I saw this Heartstopper edit that used Afterglow. Heartstopper spoilers incoming. But it was a scene where Nick and Charlie were at the canteen, and Charlie was about to break up with Nick. And Afterglow started playing in the fucking edit. But then Nick and Charlie lived happily ever after, so. Okay, at number 7, we have a close tie with the song 7 and The Lakes. Both of these songs mean a lot to me because these songs just remind me of my friends and how they continue to inspire me almost every single day. I fucking love The Lakes. And when you listen to The Lakes, I'm instantly motivated and I feel like I'm the next Virginia Woolf, which is probably not true in any way, shape, or form. But I feel like, you know, Lay, I feel like praying for Shaquan. I feel like maybe not Sylvia Plath because I'm pretty sure that woman is racist. So sorry to any of the Sylvia Plath stands out there. But I do like the music project Salvia Pulse. At number 6, we have Tolerate It. What would you do if I break free and then leave us in ruins? And then I took this fucking dagger and removed it. Believe me, I could fucking do it. She just took Shakespeare's most iconic line and made it her own fucking lyric. There's intelligent, then there's prodigy, then there's genius, and then there's Taylor Swift. I am a sole victim of being a track 5 stan. So obviously for number 5, I will be naming my favorite track 5 song, which is All Too Well. I feel like I don't need to explain this. This isn't like in your top 13 songs, like, what's going on? You know what I mean? Like, how happy are you? Like, what is going on? Like, are you just like happy? Have you never felt any sadness or melancholy in your life? We just like, whatever you have, I want it. But at the same time, like, why would I want it? Because if I had what you have, then that means I wouldn't like All Too Well. Like, you know what I mean? Like, just like fucking, anyways. At number 4, we have August. Now, if you talked to me at like 2020, this would have been my number 1, but it ranked down to number 4 because I've gone through some shit. I think August's bridge is one of the best bridges she's ever written next to Tolerate It. At number 3, we have Clean. The bass line in the beginning, if you print out the lyrics of Clean, you can literally annotate it like how you would annotate an extract for English at school. Like the imagery, the metaphors, the symbolism she uses, like, oh my fucking god. So the sun's coming down and I had to switch places. So anyway, time for my top 2 Taylor songs. At number 2, we have My Tears Ricochet. And I feel like if you are Swiftie, you would know what that song means to Taylor and just the overall vulnerability that Taylor shares with us in terms of what happened to her masters and entire catalog. A lot of people, and by people I mean misogynists, give Taylor Swift a lot of criticism for re-recording her older records. And I think it's very powerful that she's doing that because she's reclaiming her narrative. Would like to say that my number 1 favorite Taylor Swift song of all time is a very underrated song. I feel like not a lot of people will have it as their number 1 top Taylor Swift song. But my number 1 Taylor Swift song is Marjorie. Kept every grocery store receipt because every scrap of you would be taken from me. Watched as you sign your name, Marjorie. I lost my grandma, so obviously when I listen to the song, I think of my grandma. The fact that her grandmother, Marjorie, actually has backing vocals in the song is phenomenal. Like, that's fucking crazy. Yeah, that's my favorite Taylor Swift song, though. Yeah. I keep on forgetting to film an outro, but those were my top 13 favorite Taylor Swift songs. Tell me what your favorite songs are, and I will be judging you. I'm just kidding. But yeah. Bye. I forgot to include a debut song. Should have said no.